Meanwhile, a recipient of the Philippine Science Department's Budding Scientist Program makes headway in drug development as he discovers antimicrobial compounds that can be used in formulating new antibiotics. Dr. Julius Adam Lopez joins us now to discuss his discovery. Good morning, Dr. Lopez. Thanks for accepting our invitation.
Yes, good morning, Ms. Nikki and Mr. Mike. Thank you for this invitation to share our discovery in science and research.
All right. So first off, how did this idea of isolating antimicrobial compounds used in formulating new antibiotics come to be? Was there an inspiration behind this?
Oh, yes, definitely. If you look at our existing antibiotics, or the very first one, penicillin, it came from microorganisms. So it's just an unsuspecting fungus, discovered by the Nobel Prize winner Alexander Fleming. So this goes way back. And actually, we have a homegrown talent that I think is actually controversial. If you look at, if you search for the name Abelardo, Dr. Abelardo Aguilar, he was the one who discovered the microorganism from Iloilo City, from Iloilo, Panay Island. And it was later on developed by Eli Lilly Company, and it became erythromycin. The name was, the brand was Ilosone, to sort of give credit, from the source, which is Iloilo.
Mm-hmm.
We're trying to find new antibiotics from natural sources here in the Philippines.
All right, very good trivia as well for that. Thanks for that, Dr. Lopez. Now, how did you go about conducting the experiment itself that led to this discovery?
Oh, yes. This is actually part of the Philippine Marine Beta-Lactamase Inhibitor Project, which is funded by the DOST-NRCP. So I came in as a balik scientist. So I provide expertise in the actual isolation and purification of the compound. So we are a team here, it's not just me. So we have our industry partner, which is the medical city, and then we have our expert microbiologist in Dr. Dora Linda Lisay, who also went about the collection of the microorganisms of the marine bacteria. This actually came from the Tubatha Reef. So and then they identified the marine bacteria. And then I came in for the chemistry part. So the microbiologist cultured these microorganisms in the lab. And me as a chemist, I look at what are the substances that these microorganisms produce. And also this project is headed by another balik scientist, also from the University of San Agustin, Dr. Junelle Saludes. He is the project leader of this project.
And then following all that, how did being part of this initiative help you in this discovery, this budding scientist program? How does it help you? How does it support you in this?
Yes. Without the balik scientist program, we wouldn't have the capability to return to the country. I would have just stayed in Japan. I came from Japan, and this program is really a brain gain program for the Philippines in encouraging expertise abroad, Filipino experts from abroad to really return to the country, share their expertise, and help, science and research here in the Philippines. So without it would be impossible for me to return to the country.
And Dr. Lopez, let's talk about you for a sec. You have extensive experience in natural products, chemistry, and NMR spectroscopy. Can you tell us more about what this is and how we can go about learning how to use it better? What's it for?
Yes. So NMR is nuclear magnetic resonance. So if you heard about MRI, which is magnetic resonance imaging, it is the same technology. For MRI, they just removed the word nuclear because of the stigma tied to it, right? Because of the nuclear bomb. And so they intended it for medical use. But if you're the patient and you heard that this technology is nuclear magnetic resonance imaging, you may have reservations in using that technology. So they removed the nuclear part, But this is magnetic resonance, nuclear magnetic resonance. It's the same technology, but for science, we don't put the human body inside the instrument. We use a smaller version of the MRI. A smaller version of the sample holder, and we put the substance inside the instrument to characterize the structure. So a big part of my engagement is the establishment of the first 600 megahertz Bruker NMR spectrometer in the Visayas and Mindanao region, because we have NMRs, but they are all in Luzon, in UP Diliman, Ateneo, in DLSU. We do not have an NMR in the Visayas and Mindanao region. And this NMR is crucial in drug discovery programs, because this is what I use to determine the structure of the substance, to know what it is. So for example, we know drugs such as paracetamol or aspirin. At the molecular level, how do you know that it's paracetamol? How do you know that it's aspirin? If you just look at the tablet, right?
Yes, I just look at the generic name.
Yeah, you wouldn't know. You wouldn't know. So as chemists, it is our job to know what are the active substances in a particular microorganism or a particular extract.
And, Dr. Lopez, we have no less than DOST Secretary Renato Solibin Jr. also expressing his excitement about the potential impact of Filipinos gaining knowledge on using the NMR as discussed. But how can this impact not just the science, the research, but also the health industry? What kind of antibiotics are we still in need of? What kind of medicine are we still looking to come up with?
Yes. So with this Filmarine BLI project, so beta lactamase inhibitor, we are trying to address the drug resistance problem. So beta lactamase, it is like the weapon of the bacteria or the pathogen to destroy the antibiotics. So for example, you might be familiar with co-amoxiclav, which is actually a combination of amoxicillin and clavulanic acid. That's the name, co-amoxiclav. Amoxicillin is the antibiotic. Clavulanic acid is actually the beta-lactamase inhibitor. So if you take in just amoxicillin, most likely the existing pathogens right now, they're already resistant to it. No, they can readily destroy that antibiotic, making it ineffective. No, but with the beta-lactamase inhibitor, which is clavulanic acid, it destroys their weapon, which is the beta-lactamase. So if they don't have the capacity to destroy the antibiotic, then the antibiotic will be effective. Now, the problem is there's already an emergence of drug resistance to beta-lactamase inhibitors. So there are pathogens who are which are already exhibiting resistance to clavulanic acid or other existing beta-lactamase inhibitors. So we are trying to address or discover new antibiotics in the form of new beta-lactamase inhibitors with the Filmarine BLI project.
Again, to get rid of drug resistance.
Yes.
Very noble pursuit. Doctor, and do you think we need to strengthen or optimize our country's drug discovery and development path? And how can we go about doing this, and what areas need improvement when it comes to our healthcare and science and research tech?
Yes, in terms of science and research, the establishment of the NMR facility, NMR laboratory in the Visayas, is a big step in our drug discovery program. Because, we have the so-called Tuklas-Lunas program, which has been around for 10 years. The Tuklas-Lunas centers, which are part of this nationwide program to discover pharmaceuticals from natural sources, were established way back 2012. But like I said, the NMR facilities are only in Luzon. And 4 out of 5of these Tuklas-Lunas centers, which are in the drug track, or looking for new substances, are located in the Visayas and Mindanao. So with the establishment of the new NMR laboratory Visayas, this is a huge boost for the researchers who are doing drug discovery here in the Visayas and Mindanao. One thing that we need to work on is, actually there are a lot, But we do not have animal testing facilities yet, no? Which are international standards, no? So those are things that we need to work on and ask, no, other scientists to come in and help us out.
Mm-hmm. All right. On that note, thanks for joining us this morning, Dr. Lopez, and thank you for all that you do. You know, drug resistance has always been a problem with antibiotics, eh? So this is really good to hear. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for having me, and good morning, everyone.